This is Jacob Shepherd here, and I'm with the robot for your March 7th WKHS News.
NBC4 offers a $10,000 grant each year for school programs. Programs like Project Lead the Way and One Leg at a Time are competing for this grant. Micah Revilla and Noah Lawther give us the lowdown.
NBC4 Make a Difference grant is offered every year to a school program that does one of the four categories: Think, Serve, Shine, and Connect. The winner is awarded $10,000. Currently, there are two programs going for this here at Kilbourne: One Leg at a Time and the Robotics Team / STEM program.
If you received the $10,000 grant, what would you do with it?
First off, the $10,000 grant would allow a lot of our students to get training and not have to worry about paying for training, which some of our students paid for this past fall. And actually, we used a grant from Drug Safe Worthington that helped other students. So the training our students would receive would not cost them anything. And then we would also be able to utilize that money to bring in speakers for the middle school level and for the elementary schools and for the high school as well. So we already have speakers earmarked who we'd bring in, and then we would build a day around those speakers and their message. So that would be just an idea of how we would spend $10,000.
How can people vote for this group?
Voting is a little bit tricky at first, but once you get logged in, it's really easy for you to vote. And if you look at this sheet, it will tell you the shortcut, though, is to go to the URL http://nbc4i.upickem.net. Once you go to that, you need to register. Once you register, you can vote once a day. And so, you know, it just talks you through. You click on the vote tab, and then it will kick you over to the register tab. You register, then you vote. Again, you can vote once a day on your phone or on Facebook, and this tells you how to do it.
People vote for you.
Well, we'd like for them to go to the NBC4i.com website and find Make a Difference link. Click on that link. Go to the Worthington-Kilbourne High School link, which has Project Lead the Way, STEM, and FRC attached to it. Please vote starting February 24th. Vote every day from every computer you can find between February 24th to March 24th. We would certainly like to get the $10,000.
All right. If you do receive the $10,000 grant, what would you do with it?
We'll use it for a culminating project, which is the robot. For us to go to competition, it's a $5,000 grant or $5,000 entry fee each year. We spend $4,000 on the robot, so there's $9,000 of the $10,000, and we need an additional $1,000 for marketing, you know, t-shirts and things like that. So that's how the money would be spent.
All right. Remember, Kilbourne, to go online and vote every day. Michael Revilla, WKHS News.
Finding money for college isn't as hard as you think. Taylor Hoffaker gives the lowdown on some unusual scholarships.
Many students have been working their entire lives to get a good scholarship for college. But did you know that there are different ways you can get money for college? Here are some wacky scholarships I bet none of you have ever thought of. What if zombies took over your school? Would you have a plan? Submit a short essay consisting of your survival plan if zombies took over Kilbourne and receive $1,000. Are you tall but don't play ball? If you are 6'2" as a guy or 5'10" as a girl, but you don't happen to play basketball, this scholarship is for you. Do you want to be stuck at the prom? If you're looking to avoid the hassle of finding a prom dress, then create your own with duct tape and submit a photo to Duck Brand Tape to receive a $5,000 scholarship. Do you have a favorite superhero or villain? Do you often find yourself dressing up as one? If you submit a short essay about why your favorite is your favorite, you can receive $2,500 towards your education. How awesome are you? Awesome enough to receive money towards college? Submit a short essay giving the top 10 reasons why you are awesome enough and receive $1,500. While these scholarships may not be large, all the little pieces can really add up. Taylor Hoffaker, WKHS News.
Most people are familiar with Disney's Beauty and the Beast. The excitement is building to see Kilbourne's portrayal of this play tonight and tomorrow night.
Ah, Belle.
Good morning.
morning. I've come to return the book I borrowed.
Finished already?
Oh, I couldn't put it down. Have you got anything new?
Not since yesterday.
That's all right. I'll borrow...
this one.
That one? Oh, you've read it twice.
Oh, it's my favorite. Far-off places, daring sword fights, magic spells, currents in disguise.
If you like it all that much, it's yours.
But sir,
the Kilborn Repertory Theater will be presenting the well-known Disney animation Beauty and the Beast this weekend. Emily Rodriguez, who plays the main character Belle, says it's been a struggle, but it has been very fun.
How is the chemistry backstage with all of the other actors?
It's really good. We're all like getting really close, especially spending so many hours together. We've all become like pretty good friends and it's just fun. We all like to work together. We have kind of a smaller like crew, so like costume crew and set crew is a little bit more small. So a lot of our like actors like to work together too and just help everyone out.
How long have you been working on the play so far?
Well, auditions were early November, and then that was when the cast list was posted. And we started rehearsing around mid-December, and then we went all the way up until, you know, show week.
Do you have any anticipation of playing a part everyone has seen so much of?
I guess it is a little intimidating, just because it is going to be kind of hard to be compared to Belle that everyone's kind of known and heard of. But, I mean, it's going to be fun, so I'm excited. I think, you know, everyone has their own spin on every character, so it should be fun.
How well have you been able to juggle schoolwork plus the play hours?
It's not bad, especially being a senior. I don't have that many classes. Coursework isn't that hard, but I'm sure it's really difficult for everyone just because we have school, and then especially the last couple weeks, we go right into rehearsal until 6 or 7 at night, and then, you know, we're all exhausted, but we still have to get stuff done.
All right, thank you.
There she goes, that girl, a strange one special, a most peculiar mademoiselle.
It's a pity and a sin.
She doesn't quite fit in.
She really is a funny girl, a beauty, but a funny girl.
Despite all of the hard work, everyone is having fun. And make sure to come watch it tonight and tomorrow night at 7:30. Taylor Hoffaker, WKHS News.
Last Friday and Saturday, Lady Wolves gymnastic team competed in states, placing 7th as a team overall, and individuals Kayla Rice and Jacqueline Turner placing in the top 10. Here are some exciting performances from the meet. Here's Jacqueline Turner with her 6th in the state winning beam routine. And junior Kayla Rice being 10th in state OCC champion. Next up, junior Allie Geist, OCC all-around champion, bar champion, and 6th in district. Senior Celeste Fushimi Carnes, OCC First Four, Second All Around OCC Champion. Now, a memorable recap of what a great season.
This has been your WKHS News. We hope to see you at the musical.
Have a fun, safe weekend, Kilborn.